I think that a number of ways in which the state's changing, especially compared to previous growth patterns, is the state's growing slowly, more slowly. So between 2010 and 2020, the growth rate was much less, much slower than what it was in 2000 to 2010. And we also see as a part of that, a rural-urban divide that mirrors some national level trends. So in 2000 to 2010, just one Arizona county lost population. And in between 2010 and 2020, five Arizona counties lost population. And so that sort of difference between the growth in Maricopa and Pima, as well as Mojave County, versus some of the more rural counties is representative of what we're seeing nationally. And we're also seeing two other sort of takeaways, I think, is an increasingly aging population across the state, particularly in rural areas. And Arizona is becoming even more racially and ethnically diverse based on data from the past 10 years.
And just to remind our viewers, what happens with this data next?
Yeah, so the states have those redistricting files. And so many of them are busy, obviously looking at the data and processing it with respect to redrawing congressional districts, redrawing state House and Senate districts. And because of the delay, there's a lot of pressure for various states, given deadlines for candidacy filing to get the work done in time.
Jason, will there be some negative ramifications for the rural areas since the data is showing that they are shrinking in most cases here in the state of Arizona?
Yeah, I think there's going to be political shifts, not only in Arizona with respect to rural areas, but across most of the country. When we look at the decline of the population decline in rural areas, five Arizona counties lost population, and they include Apache, Cochise, La Paz, and Navajo and Gila counties. And so as a result of that, they'll have sort of less political influence in terms of the state House and Senate districts than they would compared to the previous census.
And Jason, what else are you going to be looking at in the next few months as far as this data that came out from the census?
So there's another data file that will come out in the next couple of weeks, which is a detailed set of tables relating to the redistricting data. And then, of course, we will wrap up our evaluation of the census with the post-enumeration survey to really get a sense of how accurate this census was. No census is completely accurate, unfortunately. Some people are overcounted. And some people, including the hard-to-count populations, are often undercounted. And just as an example, 2010 census was considered by many to be one of the most accurate censuses in American history. But when we look at specific racial ethnic groups, as well as data for particular hard-to-count populations, in 2010, for example, 2.1% of Black African-American individuals were missed in the census, which is roughly 800,000 Black African-American individuals. 1.5% of the Hispanic Latino population was undercounted, which is roughly 750,000 individuals. So once those data become available, we'll be evaluating those data for a better sense of how the Census Bureau did in 2020.
Jason Jurjevich, thank you very much for joining us.
Thanks, Tony. Appreciate it.